One opponent remains. 1 minute. Hold them off. All opponents down. Powerful finish.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you're doing well. Thank you for stopping by. I really do appreciate it. Hope you like that little intro. It was just for me. I just found it hilarious purely because of the fact that just a Titan charge in midair doing the Fist of Havoc never misses, ever. Like, ever. And it missed, and I just found it incredibly funny. So, what you're watching in the background, and I'm going to show you the whole game in its entirety, because I think it's important, because you can do gameplays that just show you to be an absolute beast lord, when really you're not. So, I just wanted to show you this full gameplay, just me playing. So, at the moment, I'm going for Luna's Howl. It's a subject I will be getting onto shortly. And I think in this gameplay, I'm trying to get, at the moment, I believe, precision kills. Now, if anybody's watched any of my gameplay, y'all should know that I suck ass at getting precision kills, so it probably will take me a little while, but I'm having fun doing it, and it is quite good fun, because it makes me a little bit better with hand cannons, and just having, overall, a better time with it all, really. So, yeah, I'm enjoying it. It's a grind. It's a fucking grind, especially because I'm wanting to do it solo. So that's sort of the main thing. But you'll see it a little bit in this gameplay. So the first thing that I want to talk about is how are we all feeling about Revelry? I think it's safe to say that everybody agrees that Revelry has absolutely ruined Crucible and competitive massively, as you can see all of the grenade spam going on. I mean, who in their right mind decided that this would be a good idea? I haven't even touched Iron Banner, because going into a six game with a six against a six stack that are all running the perk that gives you, or the tonic that gives you, just the constant grenades all the time. And I saw a video that BA did as well, Badass Gaming, where they literally won a game of Control by just throwing trip mines. I shit you not. Literally by just throwing trip mines, and it was literally the greatest thing that I think I've ever seen, and hilarious. It was just altogether a large amount of fun, and yeah, the Revelry thing, I don't know. I'm not sure what they were thinking. It's just one of those things, I guess. One of them silly little updates that they do to try and make things interesting and a little bit different. Yeah, that's all I can say. And that fucking air blast thing, or whatever the fuck it's called, airbender or whatever it's called, that thing is ridiculous. You don't even hear it shoot, you just suddenly explode and you've died. So there you are. So the main topic of discussion for this video is about the nerf to Luna's Howl and Not Forgotten, which I think it's fair to say has gone down well in some quarters, but majority gone down bad in some quarters. Now, I've talked about this quite a lot, specifically that it was annoying to me because of the way that the meta was going in, like when you're playing Crucible, or when you're playing, you know, when you're playing PvP, if you're going competitive, or if you go into just normal quick play or whatever, just the way that the actual games felt because of the types of weapons people were using, and that it was just a kind of little bit boring, and that if you didn't have a decent counter to Luna's Howl or Not Forgotten, that you weren't going to get very far. Now, from what I believe, it's reducing the fire rate and the little perks and bits and pieces and stuff like that, just nerfing little bits and pieces of it. Now, bearing in mind, I am going for Luna's Howl at the moment. Not Forgotten, not sure, don't know, we'll have to wait and see. However, with that being said, the thing that seems to be passing everybody by a little bit, or not passing everybody by, but I've seen it mentioned a few times, when you talk about Luna's Howl or you talk about Not Forgotten, they are pinnacle weapons. They're weapons that you have to grind your absolute nuts off for to try and achieve. The people I do feel sorry for are the people that have paid like $400 to give somebody access to their account to go and get the weapon for them, because they shouldn't really feel that annoyed by it, because it's I feel more sorry for the people that have really, really grinded their ass off for a pinnacle weapon. And that's the whole point of a pinnacle weapon. They're supposed to be strong. They're hard to get, and they're hard to get for a reason. So the reward for having put yourself through all that shit should be that you get a pinnacle weapon that's good. That's just kind of my opinion. I don't think it needed a nerf. I don't think Not Forgotten needed a nerf. I just think what they needed to do was some sandbox changes to just kind of address the meta issue a little bit. That was it. I don't really think it needed a nerf at all. And I, like I said, you know, I'm going for it myself, so kind of maybe I'm slightly biased by it, because you think, oh Christ, I'm grinding for it, and what's the point? But I'm still going to do it. I'm still going to get it. I don't think Bungie, it seems like, and I saw Frostbolt do a video on it, and a point he made was quite good. It seems like they're trying to move away from the gun skill and make it more about abilities, where I kind of think that it should be 50-50, but they're kind of focusing more on the ability side of things. That's where it seems like we're going, which is, it's kind of wrong for me. It should be 50-50. And the big difference, or the big change, or the thing that is really, really weird, is that across platforms, it's completely different. On PC, hand cannons are absolutely, like, ridiculously immense. Like, really, really good, really fun to use, work really, really well. On console, it's slightly different, because you've got Bloom, you've also got that weird flinch sort of situation that goes on as well. So they're not as, they're good, don't get me wrong, and if you're a good player, you're going to be really, really good with them, but they're not as, when I've watched players on PC playing, it's almost like I'm watching a different game, because you watch it on console and it just all feels a little bit different. That's just the best way that I can describe it. So I am kind of annoyed that they are nerfing it. I'm not annoyed in the sense that something needed to be done. I just don't think that a nerf was the right thing to do, just purely because it's a pinnacle weapon, and that's the key element of it. And pinnacle weapons should be hard to get, and when you get them, you should be able to reap the rewards of having that pinnacle weapon. What they needed to do was make other guns viable, bring some other guns up a little bit, so that, for me, so they could counter, or have the ability to counter pinnacle weapons. So not that pinnacle weapons were the best weapons out there to the demise of absolutely everything else. They should be strong, absolutely, but you should have some form of counter there, or some form of counter that you can put in with it. I guess that's it. It's kind of a really weird, about strange kind of thing that I'm saying. I know I'm kind of making sense, sort of, if that makes sense. I don't know. But, yeah, I see a lot of people annoyed about it, but this is Bungie all over. It's what they do. They try and change things up a little bit and make changes, and often it's not the right sorts of changes. It's like, where are the new PvP maps? There should be some more new PvP maps. There just should, and there isn't, and they should be focusing on that to keep people playing and keep people interested. Like I said, it's all about the content, and that's what's lacking with this game, content. And the Revelry thing is a load of shit. Skip Grenade 2, the movie. That's going to do it for this one. If you've enjoyed it, click the like button. If you're new to the channel, please also don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for stopping by and listening to me ramble on as ever. We're out of here, ladies and gentlemen. Peace. Jackson.